recent misadventures? Is he just in denial? Is he just delusional?
He began boxing as a portly 11-year-old 15 years ago.
Just as was the case a month ago for Floyd.
In particular, why they have the shot. See there?
And he gets caught with a big left-hand counterpunch shot. Yeah, and for the left hook to the body, but he is hurt. He has definitely been wobbled. Cotto's been hurt before and has always fought back well.
And it was an accidental shot.
Two jabs. One of his downfalls in some past fights has been Cotto seems devoted to trying to make his jab a factor early.
Uppercuts of his.
Combination and that left hook to the body, his money punch.
Cotto's left jab is being more effective than Zab's jab.
There's the left hook to the body.
Cotto's going to keep doing that over and over and over.
Miguel Cotto's
fight. It looks like he's looking for the perfect punch. To throw the round by hoping for the perfect punch.
Blood is coming from. And now Cotto seems to want to do damage right away. Hard left hand inside by Judah.
Sweeping right hand that he's been working on and training is the last thing that he needs to throw tonight because he can.
Patient of imploding.
There it is again.
Judah.
There it is again.
Judah may be trying to buy a penalty point at this point.
Second round, the third round, that goes in, won it again. And
sad. Meanwhile, Judah is bleeding outside his right eye.
And keep in mind,
and Cotto starting with Judah around the ring with his wider, stronger. Both fighters are looking from time to time at Mercanti, but Julie stops Cotto's assault. Left hook to the body by Cotto. One of the problems for Zab Judah in some of his big fights, the pressure build, he's trying to hammer away.
Jab again.
You're looking at blood on both fighters. You're looking at physical war.
Do anything illegal, I thought, for the most part. Zab was holding on.
That was raised before the fight. Was would Judah be able to hurt?
Take advantage of it. There's a shot at that big counter left. Landed 20, 25 left. He's landing only 13% of them.
That's out. Back on the break accidentally.
Watch that elbow, Zab!
I think the way Cotto
initiates the offense. That would normally be the case against a conventional fighter. But he hurts Judah with a right hand.
Looks like he's stunned.
It's the sledgehammer force of the shots. It's the commitment that and speed, still superior, still very dangerous to everything.
And he's winning the territorial battle because he's the one 5-1.
Zab Judah starting to blink with the right eye. Cotto dipping under Judah as he looks to get to the body. Judah's blood starting to flow above Judah's right eye. Judah rips Cotto with a left-hand shot. Catches him with a... The will of Miguel Cotto. Resurface.
It's a fight that whenever...
I've seen Corey Spinks. He's...
Good body shot by Miguel Cotto. Combination upstairs by Cotto. Judah spending most of this round. He's trying to get away.
Systematically, Cotto is breaking him down.
Away at Judah and gets the blood to flow from Judah's right eye again. Left, right, left.
In the past, we've seen Cotto get a little reckless when he thought he had a man that he could.
Rounds 9 and 10 on, he's been brutal and relentless. And more strikingly, Judah only threw 32 punches. He needs to throw more. The vicious assault. Arthur Mercanti watching closely. Judah goes.
Knockout.
As if Miguel needed any further evidence. Hard left hand by Judah.
He dropped to one knee because he couldn't see out of that right eye. 7-2, Cotto.
something off of it in the 10th. And he's trying. Back into the south cross dance. Back into in many of his performances, Larry.
Absolutely.
Yeah. He's got a lot of credibility he regained tonight in this.
Followers will point to the two low blows early and say, what would have happened if he didn't? Very early in the fight.
Jeremy, that's exactly what's reading my mind. That's what I was thinking about. He's been punched.
Let's go. After the knockdown and the ninth, Judah landed two big shots. He doesn't want it.
Cotto. Miguel Cotto.